So what happens when you spend your entire season fishing only in the Quabbin Reservoir, and in doing so, learning how to use a brand new updated rig with all new electronics? Well, you're about to find out.
This guy was down 55 feet. Lake trout, little guy. I was dragging him for a while. Didn't even realize I had him hooked on. It's a good jump, but I couldn't quite make it out.
That's good. Awesome.
Let's look before he goes. We're gonna let that rainbow go.
Sweet fish. Where do you want to go?
Same as we just did. You bang one out any minute.
You do.
Lake trout number 3. Going back.
I'm getting there for 5.
We're like 5th. We got here just a few minutes before 5. And the line's already backed up. John just happens to be behind me with his tracker.
you got the method for Lakers now. There's actually fish that like my rod.
He almost looked shocked that something bit it.
I was like, what? What can that be?
Is this real? Start hearing to the left. Yeah. Rainbow, this time I got it. Decent one. All right, we're gonna let some fish go. Laker number one. Number two. Laker number three. Here's a 2-pound rainbow. I'm gonna let him go too. Dale threw it out before I had to get the camera. Two fish on.
Downrigger was just popping up and down. Hopefully it's in.
Smallmouth. Not what I want.
Check this one out. All scarred up from the eagles. Talon marks. Crazy.
end of the season. Before I picked up Anthony at the dock, I was doing some bass fishing before we started trolling for some salmon. I got this monster small enough. Female full of eggs. I'm gonna let her go. But I wanted to get a quick clip, a quick couple of pictures before letting her back. Smallmouth, biggest one so far this year. Bass fishing earlier at another spot. Big belly.
It's long, right?
Right now we're trolling to try to get a mixed bag of some salmon. I'm a multi-species guy, but I got into the smallmouth earlier. Beautiful big fat female. Pre-spawn fish, and then this one's probably about 3 pounds. Could be bigger, maybe just a little smaller compared to the fish. I don't know. Probably weighed the big one. I'm gonna let him go, put him, loose him back in the original spot where I caught him. It was a good day of bass fishing for sure. A lot of fun. All right, we're gonna let a giant bass go. Weighed on 2 digital scales. Monster. We got this one trolling incidentally, but I'm just showing it to you because I love that tiger pattern on it. All right, it's Thursday. I'm only doing a half a day. It's just a little bit before 6, opening time of Quabbin. Let's see what we can do today. I'm at gate 31. And hopefully we have some luck. We shall see. Lake trout. Caught it off a sucker. Yeah, he took a pretty big bait. I just lost a salmon, son of a bitch. Thank you. Here's one off the loaded for bass spinnerbait. Bad one. All right, we're gonna let some bass go.
Time to go.
Wow, look at the size of that thing. Jeez. What'd that weigh?
I don't know. We're gonna find out.
No trolling, just bass fishing. I pulled out another hog that I'm fortunate to get. Check out this slob. Not quite 5 pounds, but pretty close to it. Pre-spawn fish. We'll back shortly. Time to go fishing. Come on, salmon, bite. Salmon number two. bass. Decent one.
Beautiful smallmouth.
Just pulled up to do a troll. Earlier I was bass fishing, I got another big guy. This one's a 4.5. It's about 21 inches long. Beauty. Pre-spawn fish. I'm gonna go put it right back where I found it. Lost a monster salmon. Almost had him in the net. It's tough controlling the boat and trying to reel up a fish when you're by yourself. Damn it. Banged out another smallmouth. Fat. I got this one incidentally while trolling. I hate catching them when I'm trolling. When I'm trolling, I want to get the salmon and the trout. When I'm bass fishing, I just want to get the smallmouth. So this is bittersweet. Had a rainbow today. Oh. Had a rainbow today. Got a nice lake trout. It's pouring out. We're about to head in. But this was the booby prize of the day. Mike got some nice smallmouth. He lost a nice landlock. We got a couple of hits. It's pouring rain, and we got to get out of here before the thunder hits. And I lost my hat. All right, Mike got a couple of smallmouth. It's pouring out. The rain's coming in. And we're about to get the hell out of here. These are our booby prizes for the day. Mike did hook up with the landlock and we lost a couple, but we'll get them another day.
Got a monster jumbo perch. Feel the size of this thing. Belly. Beautiful.
This trophy perch. Look at the size of that jumbo perch. 15 and a half inches. Beautiful. Monster perch. Fat belly on it.
Salmon go. Ooh.
Folks, it's been a grind. So I'm sitting there minding my own business, taking pictures of loons with my Nikon camera while trolling. Off in the distance I hear a helicopter, but I don't think much of it, until it's suddenly hovering over me. I didn't think to video it at the time since I already had my camera at hand, so I just instinctively began snapping pictures of it. If you look close enough at the pictures, one of the guys is taking pictures too with his camera phone. There were plenty of other boats around, so I was perplexed as to why they continued to hover over me. I guess I'll never really know, but it certainly complemented the day's stories.
I just got a decent retro. Not bad. Bad little lake trout. Nice. Doing some summer bass fishing. The spawn is totally over. Still managed to scrape up this 3.5 pounder. Beautiful fish. Took a loaded for bass spinnerbait. Been having some luck on them. Nice bass, for sure. Another decent one on a spinnerbait.
I just landed a salmon in a rainbow, a double. Wow. The first.
Check it out. Summertime salmon. Hook jaw kite male. Beautiful. And a nice fat rainbow. If I couldn't believe it. Fatty. There's not just smallmouth in here, there's largemouth too.
Left, got it.
Trout that Steve was supposed to grab.
It almost fell in the water.
That's a big fish.
Pulling it out.
Good. Good. Yeah. Get the downrigger up so I'm not worried about getting stuck. Now turn the boat so I can net it better.
Clear.
Just keep reeling. When I tell you to step back and raise your rod tip straight up, do it, because that's when I'm going to net it.
Okay, I gotcha.
All right, I'm actually going to get in front of you once that fish gets closer. No. Actually, get in the corner right now. Yep.
All right, here he is, right here.
Okay, here we go. Turn the boat. Hang on. Nope, we're too hard to use. Back up, slowly back up. Oh, look at the size of that thing.
Go up to the wrist of the tail, squeeze it, lift, and then hold like that.
Put your hands under the pecs.
Yep.
Toward me like that. Okay. And straighten that fish out.
There he is.
All right. Carefully place him in the water. Yep.
I didn't know I was dragging this little tiny laker all this time.
What on earth do I have? This is so good.
Summertime salmon. Love it. All right. Glad I decided to fish the Quabbin over the summer.
It's August 6th and I just banged out this beautiful landlocked salmon. Down deep. Gorgeous fish.
Back up. I knew you got bit.
The wifey just banged out this cute little lake trout. New lure I'm trying out. Wonder bread.
Okay.
All right, he's got another lake trout. Another lake trout. They're small, but we'll take them.
This one's easy to get out.
Another lake trout.
My wife decides she's going to sunbathe and read her book instead of haul up the next fish, which just happened to be a big one. I end up reeling it up. Figures.
I took my wife out today. We're into the Lakers. This one's nice and fat. I'm going to toss it in right now. I'm going to squeeze the belly, get some of that air out. Oh, she's full. All right. Fiber here. She swims off.
We're working on number 8. We hauled up most of them. You're gonna keep on doing that. Fingers crossed.
How's it feeling?
Okay.
I'm gonna try to get it right straight down the middle here. Bring it to the right. big lake trout.
You're doing fine.
We should be able to get this one.
Back up if you can, reel. Back up. Keep going. Back up, baby. Good luck. That's a big fish.
The wifey got a nice one. Look at this one. You ready, baby?
Yes.
Yeah. Beauties today. I don't keep too many, but these are gonna go for the barbecue tonight with my family. Awesome looking fish. Pretty stoked to get them. Nice rainbow, nice salmon. Late August. Lager, I got the big three as far as cold water fish today. Baby. We can do better than that. Not a giant, but I'll take him. Thank you.
rainbow trout.
Had a huge hit earlier. It was a salmon that came off before people grabbed the rod. But this is what I get first thing, though. Not a bad start.
Down. Baby Laker. That's what I've been dragging around.
There you go.
I'm tag teaming with John. We got our boats together. Bass fishing. John just pulled one out, about 3 pounds. Beauty. Let me go zoom in, John.
Nice gut.
Getting some deep water fish.
Got some bait fish down there. Mm-hmm. They're mowing.
Get some more.
Early morning start. Let me go again. It's another early morning. Dark out. Hitting the road, seeing if we can get into some nice fish today. Fingers crossed.
Baby. We'll be right back. Another baby. Looking for something bigger.
Took the f***ing bait with it. Oh. I guess it was a bad knot.
It's nasty out today. Another undersized trout that couldn't be kept legally, that didn't make it, coming up 90 feet, that isn't gonna go to waste. I've been getting a lot of little dinks. This weekend, finally, got a big boy. Pretty happy with that one. Beauty. Another decent laker.
Never really targeted lake trout as much as this year. Summertime lake trout fishing. Fishing close to bottom. Get them in the summertime for sure. Beautiful. I love this stuff.
Summertime's a great time to chase lake trout. But a lot of these rats, they're all fun though. John got a nice 3-pounder off his bass tracker. I'm next to him, also drop shot. Sunrise at the Quabbin Reservoir. This is how to start the day. Let's see what today brings. Since I got one of these, I was wondering if I still knew how to catch them. This one's a male. Got a kite on it, a racer, a little fin. Beautiful guy. All right, let this salmon go. One of many lake trout caught this year. I'm bass fishing and I caught a rainbow on the drop shot. How about that? A lot of rainbows this year. They started stocking more from what I hear, because I've never caught so many rainbows at Quabbin. It's been a great season for them.
Took a break from trolling, drop shotting for bass. Couldn't get it on film, but it's got this nice bad boy. Beauty. Quality fish. Not bad, right? About 40 feet over 66 feet. He hit it so softly I barely even noticed he took it. I kind of just really went to check it. Sure enough, he was there. He put up a great fight with a decent fish for sure. Awesome. Show you what I'm doing here. So this is live scope, and fishing over 62 feet of water, and I'm hitting fish at 40 feet, 50 feet. I'm just literally, it's like video game fishing, just dropping it down right in front of their face, or dropping it down near them, and the feeding fish will approach it, sometimes with thrust and force, and the bigger fish seem to be a little more cautious. They come up to it and then they kind of investigate it and either hit it or they don't. And that's what it looks like. I got it in the emerald green. There's a fish right there on the bottom. And some bait right there. It's a great system with a Garmin force that locks me in position. It's keeping me right on the spot. Anchor lock position, which is that white anchor, is telling me that it's on. So that's the key for today anyway. It's been so much fun just watching the fish come up and take it that I kind of glad I got the unit. I just wasn't sure whether it was wise or not because it wasn't cheap, but well worth it, especially if you, particularly if you're a diehard smallmouth guy. First season using it, having a blast with it, really only started utilizing it over the summertime. But I'm looking forward to many seasons with that setup. Live scope, thumbs up. Look at the size of that white perch. Never caught one before. I heard there were some slabs in here. Sure enough, beauty. He's hooked up. He's in the fighting chair now. The marlin. No head shakes?
For what?
Nice smallmouth. Bass is there. Not a dick like the other ones.
Yeah, there it is.
Wasn't a bad size. Hopefully we get small like that later when we're actually trying to catch them. As soon as that fish is further away from us, you'll see him come down and dive down.
Oh, he didn't want it again.
Nope, coming back.
Coming back.
You got it. Nice. So we stopped trolling to drop shot for bass, but I didn't have my camera set up and ready to go on the bow. But we got a bunch of dink bass though, but the most notable fish caught was this 2 or 3 pound rainbow I landed.
Early morning star. Look at that spot. What do you see in front of me earlier?
smallest fish I've ever caught on a blade. It's as big as the bait. That is one ambitious smallmouth, I'll tell you. All right, there's some more fish on the graph. Got live scope, panoptics.
That line went into the prop. I had to bring up my trolling motor to get the line out of the prop. It's a miracle. That happened to me last week with a big one. It came off the head for the prop. I'm sitting here drop shotting again. The trolling bite was slow. He had a pretty decent one. He's not a giant, but he's a good one. He was eyeing it, watching him, and he's sitting and he's hovering right next to it. And I kind of just let it drop down and let it flutter and did that a couple times and he finally took it. It was a soft bite too. I just kind of lifted up on the rod and boom, he was hooked. Smart fish though. Gotta check my line, make sure it's not frayed up. Wow, he wasn't coming off as far as the hook goes. Bad. What's wrong with that? Another nice swamp. Maybe I should net him after all. It's been a slow pick, but I've been getting them. Pretty solid too. Well, not as big as I thought. Getting them on the live scope, a lot of fun. I've caught plenty of fish without live scope, but it's a nice to have. You don't absolutely need it. The lights on my gauge is turned on. It's still dark out. Night mode. Second last weekend of the Quabbin season. First fish of this weekend. I got this nice rainbow I just bagged out. Beautiful colors on it. They stocked some extra rainbows this year, and it shows because I'm getting a lot this year. Nice bonus fish to catch. Pretty fish. Not net worthy.
Just another lake trout. Small one.
Third one today. Got a rainbow earlier. Air out of them so you can push them back down. Hopefully he grows up to be a 14 fish.
There
we
go.
Not what I had in mind, but oh well. Thank you.
just got another rainbow. This one is a nice one, though. This one's bigger than the last one. Look at this slob.
That's got to go 4 pounds. Whatever, it's a nice one. Beautiful fish. I'm going to measure it momentarily.
Awesome. 21 inch. Gorgeous rainbow.
Beautiful. Another pinfish. I've been having a good year here, for sure. She's going to go back soon. I'm going to let her revive again on the live well before I release her.
My lure unfortunately snagged someone's anchor.
That's somebody else's lure.
Toss this trash instead of putting it back in the white.
All right, we're gonna let some fish go, including a state pin rainbow trout.
So I like to participate in the Massachusetts Freshwater Fishing Awards program. Last season I was fortunate enough to earn 10 bronze pins and win another gold pin and plaque for the catch and release smallmouth category. Since Mass Wildlife goes through all the trouble of running this program, I figured at the very least I should show my appreciation and show up to the award ceremony. But unfortunately, due to the continued pandemic precautions, this year's ceremony was held virtually, Zoom meeting style. During the ceremony, they highlighted all the fish species and the numbers of pins given out for each of the categories. I found it interesting how abundant the numbers were for most species except for two categories, tiger muskies, in which only one pin was given out, and lake trout, in which only 10 were given out. As you can see, the program gives biologists much-needed data to help them manage the fisheries. During the virtual event, I was pleased to see a bunch of familiar faces and some friends also being awarded. Congratulations to all the winners. As far as Quabbin goes, there are no delays and the reservoir will open on time. I'll see you out there soon. Good luck to everyone this season. Tight lines, be safe, and cheers.